From the Reunion Arena in Dallas, we are at the final stop before Unforgiven this Sunday. Tonight, Val Venus takes on Al Snow on a night where Al will also learn of the stipulation for his match at Unforgiven, where he will challenge the Big Boss Man for the Hardcore title. Tonight, we will also see a gauntlet match take place, featuring the competitors from the WWF title 5-way match at Unforgiven. Stone Cold Steve Austin is not medically clear tonight as he is still suffering from the effects of the sledgehammer attack from Triple H last week. But rest assured, he will be ready to go come Unforgiven in Charlotte. This means that replacing him in the gauntlet tonight will be the Big Show. And should Show be successful in winning the entire gauntlet, then he will be entered into the 5-way at Unforgiven, thus making it a 6-way match. He's going to have to go the distance though, as he will be kicking things off versus the champion Triple H in mere moments. Every match in the gauntlet will all have its own unique stipulation, of which we will be informed of just before each match begins. Coming up first, it's going to be a chokeslam match between the Big Show and the Game. The first one to chokeslam their opponent will be declared the winner and thus advances to the next match in the gauntlet. Let's go to the ring. Underway here, who will be the first to chokeslam their opponent to the mat? Big Show obviously with the clear advantage. The entire WWF still reeling from the conclusion to Raw this past Monday as Triple H destroyed Vince and Shane McMahon with his sledgehammer. There's no McMahon presence on this show tonight as a result. We also saw Stephanie McMahon appearing, trying to make Triple H stop the brutal assault. Stephanie's former boyfriend Test also got involved until Stone Cold Steve Austin ended things for good when he made an unexpected appearance. Stone Cold advised by the doctors to not engage in physical activity until Unforgiven, but Austin definitely not heeding that advice lately. There was no way he was going to be clear to compete tonight though. Big Show was absolutely dominant on Raw as his sheer power and strength done damage to The Rock and Mankind, throwing them off the stage and then the ladder onto Steel. Show absorbing these kicks. And Triple H going for the choke slam, but he couldn't get Show off the ground. If Show hits this, he wins it. And there you have it, Big Show, the winner of the choke slam match. In the gauntlet is going to be Kane. This will be an over the top rope challenge. Only way to win is to send your opponent over the top rope with both feet hitting the floor. But wait, Undertaker and Viscera attacking X-Pac backstage. X-Pac, Kane's former tag team partner, they've gone their separate ways but they're still friends, and this is surely a ploy by Taker to get back at the Big Red Machine. X-Pac needs some help there, but Kane is in the middle of a match. We need to get that brawl up on the Titantron. Kane now up against the ropes. Count as the boot. That could have been it there. Now Show in trouble. Kane building up ahead of steam. But Show sidesteps. Kane has no idea his former tag team partner X-Pac is being beat up by Undertaker and Viscera backstage. Now this assault is stretched out here. Taker and his goons are trying to goad Kane into this, it looks like. Near 300 pound weight difference here between X-Pac and Viscera. And X-Pac has already taken one hell of a beating. Only getting worse there with that body slam on the steel ramp. But Kane sending Big Show up for the choke slam. And I think Kane is ready to win this and throw Big Show over the top. But Viscera has dragged X-Pac all the way down the ramp. Big splash, insult to injury. Kane going up top. He's thinking if this is a good idea or not. Clothesline off the top. Kane saving X-Pac from a further beating. But in doing so, he eliminated himself from the match, thus giving Big Show the win. Kane wanted to take out Viscera instantly, and the big clothesline allowed him to do that. The trade-off being he's lost the match, and now the Big Red Machine taking it to Viscera. Doesn't look like he's showing any signs of stopping, but this could be another trap set up by The Undertaker. The Big Show is your winner. But hang on, Mankind now getting involved in this brawl. I believe Taker was waiting for Viscera and Kane to come back through the ramp so the Dead Man could attack his brother, but Mankind is due out next in the gauntlet. X-Pac still on the outside, and oh no, Big Show is gonna further punish Sean Waltman there with that chokeslam on the floor. Mankind's got Viscera double arm DDT head first on concrete, and now the mandible claw. Viscera is completely incapacitated, and Mankind is headed to the ring. Yeah. And funny enough, the stipulation for this next match in the gauntlet is no interference, meaning all superstars are banned from ringside. And after all that's just transpired, maybe that is for the best. X-Pac and Viscera hurt badly in that melee there, no doubt. X-Pac was able to walk out of here with some assistance from the medical team, however it's clear he will not be 100% going into Unforgiven on account of the beating he just suffered. He takes on Chris Jericho this Sunday in Charlotte. Taker's now all alone. Rock and Kane have cornered him. It's believed Taker was trying to leave the arena whilst in a scuffle with Kane, but The Rock has entered the fray. It's been months and months of The Rock, Kane and Mankind going at it with Show and Taker, but Taker is now in a position which he has not found himself throughout this feud, and that is on his own at a man disadvantage, all while taking a beating in the process. Hard landing on the choke slam as Taker's ankle collided with the car on the way down, and now Rock bottom and Kane's getting into the forklift. Taker is out. Show's watching this on the Tron. No! Taker sandwiched between the forklift and the car. Show was watching on the Tron, but Mankind schoolboys him. Mankind advances to the final of the Gauntlet vs. The Rock. We're back on SmackDown. I don't think we can put into words what just transpired, but we will try. As Big Show was facing Mankind in the ring, Kane and Undertaker would continue their brawl into the parking lot where another rival of Taker and Big Show, The Rock, would get involved. Kane's been at odds with Undertaker since day one here in the WWF, where the beating we saw of X-Pac tonight was just the final straw for the Big Red Machine. We've never seen Kane so full of rage. He was completely out of control to the point where he would get in a forklift and sandwich his own brother between the vehicle and another car. It was a sickening attack. And Undertaker has been loaded into an ambulance that was on site. We hope to get an update on his condition before we go off the air tonight. But he's gone too far tonight. Regardless, the show must go on. Our main event still to come. It will be Rock vs. Mankind in the Boiler Room Brawl later on. Al Snow taking on Val Venus first. But Al is running out of the ring again. Boss Man waiting for him on the ramp. Boss Man meant to reveal the stipulation for the match at Unforgiven vs. Al, and he said it's going to be a cage match, oh boy. But straight back to the ring, Blackman stalking his opponent come Unforgiven, Val Venus. Blackman kendo stick in hand, we know he retrieved his double bag previously stolen by Val. Val once again telling Blackman to divert his attention to the left of the ring, and Stevie Richards again playing dress up, this time as Val Venus, and that looks like Mark Henry's tell from last Sunday on Heat. Val, big smile on his face, but it's put up or shut up at Unforgiven, no more games as Val collides with Steve Blackman. It's coming your way in 3 nights from Charlotte, North Carolina. When we come back, we'll run down the rest of the card for Unforgiven and present you with our main event of the evening, the final encounter in the Gauntlet match as Mankind faces The Rock in a Boiler Room Brawl. Unforgiven this Sunday will feature a 5-way match for the WWF Championship as Triple H defends against Kane, a medically cleared to compete Stone Cold, The Rock and Mankind. The Intercontinental title will be on the line as badass Billy Gunn challenges the ninth wonder of the world, China. Former good friends and tag partners do battle when D'Lo Brown looks to regain the European Championship versus Sexual Chocolate Mark Henry. The Dudley Boys and the Acolytes will finally collide after a series of sneak attacks from Bubba and Devon on Bradshaw and Baruch. Chris Jericho looks to continue his good start in the WWF, but he'll face his biggest challenge yet in an albeit not 100% X-Pac after the assault he suffered tonight. The Hardcore title will be up for grabs in what we now know will be a cage match, the stipulation chosen as such so that Al Snow cannot run away and take the fight elsewhere, as the Big Boss Man defends his Hardcore title against Al Snow. But without any further ado, let's send it down to the Boiler Room where The Rock has just entered as we await the start of the final match of the Gauntlet. The Rock is in the Boiler Room, this match ready to get underway. The only way to win is to successfully leave the Boiler Room by exiting through the door. Tag team champions against one another here. They have certainly set the WWF alight while they have been partners, but let's not forget they were bitter rivals first. Who could forget the legendary battles these men had at the Royal Rumble in January, or how about the empty arena match during halftime heat? They will be opponents once again come Unforgiven. The Boiler Room, the Dungeon of Mankind, this match his speciality. Just this past Monday on Raw, his actions burned the face of Midian, who was out of action indefinitely as a result. The same might be said for Viscera, who Mankind drove headfirst into tile flooring earlier with a double arm DDT. As for The Undertaker, initial reports from the EMTs believe Taker has suffered a torn groin and a broken ankle as a result of the assault from Kane and The Rock in the parking lot. And most notably, when Kane drove a forklift into the ground, Taker sandwiching him between the forklift and a car, absolutely devastating. How about The Rock's reaction when that went down? He was just as perplexed and shocked as all of us were. Kane was able to see everything that happened to X-Pac after the fact through our production screens in the backstage area. It's believed that upon seeing the tape tape of what happened, Kane was briefly distracted just enough time for The Undertaker to make his way into the parking lot to where Kane would then follow him. Rock and Mankind are the tag champs, might even be friends, but when it comes to wanting to be the best, these two are as competitive as they come. Big Show entering the boiler room, and he is seeking revenge for Undertaker, Viscera and Midian too, probably. Show is the last man standing between all of them men. They've all been put on the shelf, with the Big Show standing taller than he ever did. And if his actions on Raw are anything to go by, then tonight is going to be even worse, you would imagine. Oh, good lord. Show throwing Mankind over his head onto the steel. And now he's set his sights on The Rock. This is not over, and it's not going to be over until Big Show is through with everyone that he believes has wronged him and The Undertaker. But there's no smoke without fire, as the saying goes. Show throwing Rock through the door, and technically The Rock has won this match, but at what cost? It's Kane. He has one more man to deal with, and it's the Big Show. Full Nelson slam, and you hear that thud on the ground. Show in trouble. This could be a repeat of the Taker attack. Triple H and Austin going at it. It's believed Triple H was about to interrupt that brawl with a sledgehammer, but Austin arrived just in time. It's this Sunday, one prize, the WWF title, five men, Unforgiven.